Genesis is applied with ECS combined with the air spring of Teves and continuously damping control damper. At first, let's have a look at the system comparison. The ECS system installed at Centennial is called the open loop system. For Genesis, it is called the closed loop system. Open loop system spring and the damper are separated and the target pressure is about 8.5 bar. Damper can adjust the damping force according to road surface condition. The reservoir tank is installed at the lower left side of front bumper. Its capacity is about 5.2 liter and the pressure is about 10 to 14 bar. The reservoir tank supplies the compressed air to air spring using compressor during increasing level. When descending level, it stores the air of air spring. The compressor is installed at the lower right side of front bumper. It supplies the compressed air in the system to the compressor or air spring, and it dries the air using the dryer. The solenoid valve block is installed at the lower of right side headlamp beside compressor. It comprises of 5 solenoid valves, pressure sensor, and air port. By the operation of the solenoid valve, the air port of the pneumatic circuit will open or close. G sensors are installed at the back of both sides headlamp. An additional G sensor is installed at the left of trunk for measuring the vertical gravity acceleration of vehicle. The signal output is 0.5 to 4.5 volts. While the vehicle is stationary, it outputs 2.5 volts. For height sensor, each one sensor is installed at each suspension, so totally 4 suspensors are installed. They use 5-volt power source and output pulse width modulation signal. They detect the vehicle level and vertical gravity acceleration. This is the waveform measured from the rear height sensor at normal mode. Control mode is located at trunk left side, and the variant coating should be performed after replacing. In addition, after replacing the height sensor or control module, height sensor calibration should be performed. The method for height sensor calibration is that in ignition on state, select height sensor calibration menu in the scanner and ECS control module is lowering the vehicle level and then lifting up. At this time, when the level detected by control module is shown, measure the actual level directly and enter it to scanner in order to verify the vehicle height. For input elements, there are battery power, height sensor, G sensor, pressure sensor, and ECS switch. For CAN communication items, there are engine torque, brake signal, steering angle, ABS and ESC signal, and intake air temperature signal. For output elements, there are 4 solenoid valves supplying the compressed air to the air spring, ambient valve, reversing valve, compressor relay, damper solenoid valve, height sensor power supply, and pressure sensor power supply. For the operating principle, control module receives the value of G sensor detecting vertical gravity acceleration of vehicle and the value of height sensor detecting level, and changes the oil path in the damper based on the calculated value to control the damping force of the vehicle. For manual control of the damping force, press the sport switch at the left side of the shift lever, then illumination will be flashed. Upon pressing it again, the illumination will be off. When replace air spring or install the air spring, the compressed air should be filled using the air filling machine. The first method for air filling is like that. First, check that the vehicle is on the lifter properly. Second, connect the air hose to the air inlet port in the air filling machine and open the intermediate valve. Third, by operating of internal compressor of air filling machine, the pressure of 5 bar will be increased up to 12 bar. If the air pressure reaches 12 bar in the internal tank of machine, the operating sound of compressor will be stopped. Fourth, connect the air filling nozzle to the air filling valve at the left side of engine room. Between reservoir tank and air filling valve, there is check valve. When compressed air pushes the check valve and moves to reservoir tank, whistle sound may be heard. If the whistle sound is not heard anymore, the air filling of reservoir tank is completed. Finally, using scanner, supply air into the air spring. Selecting the relevant menu of scanner, air is supplied to the front air spring at first, and then supplied to the rear air spring. There is a caution for air filling. Since the rear air spring is separating type without aluminum guide, when the compressed air is leaked out, then it will be easy to be buckled. If air is filled under this condition, air spring may not be settled properly. Therefore, when filling air into rear air spring, hold the side surface of air spring with hand to settle it to chassis module. Because only 2 bolts of 10 mm can support the air spring at lower part of rear air spring. For checking noise of rear chassis frame or front suspension, air should be discharged to remove the air spring. At this time, using scanner, air in the air spring can be discharged. There are 7 items on the scanner menu. If required, the compressed air at one or several portions can be discharged. This is the pneumatic circuit for system air filling. Connecting the air filling nozzle with air filling valve, whistling sound can be heard during filling the pressure into reservoir tank. According to the order from scanner, the reversing valve will open and the compressor will operate. After that, solenoid valves open to supply the compressed air into air spring. This is the pneumatic circuit for lifting the level. The compressed air of reservoir tank is compressed by the compressor through the reversing valve. The solenoid valve is opened by control module so that the compressed air is supplied into the air spring. This is the pneumatic circuit for lowering the level. Control module opens the solenoid valve and the reversing valve so that the air can reaches to the front of the compressor. After that, the air compressed by the compressor passes through the dryer, check valve, and reversing valve, and is stored in the reservoir tank. That is, at every time of level descending, the moisture in the air is eliminated by dryer. Air discharging, dryness. According to the control module internal logic, moisture of system will be eliminated. This sequence is as follows. The compressed air in the reservoir tank moves to the orifice through the reversing valve. Passing the orifice means that the airspeed in orifice is faster, while the airspeed will be slow after passing the orifice. When speed is slow, the air can content more amount of moisture in dryer and go out. The level can be changed automatically by the control logic. At normal level, when driving over 120 km per hour for 10 seconds or more, it will be changed to low level, so that the level is lower than normal mode by 15 millimeters. At low level, upon driving less than 40 kilometers per hour, the level will be lifted to normal level immediately. However, there will be a time delay of 5 seconds to move normal level if the vehicle speed is lower than 80 kilometers per hour. At high level, upon driving over 70 kilometers per hour for 10 seconds or more, it automatically lowered to normal level. When the vehicle is on the lifter, lifting platform mode will be performed. Regardless of ignition status, if height sensor detects the level elevation, control module discharges the air from the front air springs. Even if air is discharged, the level is not changed. Lifting platform mode starts and the air discharging will stop. When the vehicle is laid down on the ground, level will be in full rebound condition. However, the level will be lifted by operation of compressor upon ignition switch off and on. Control module enters into the sleep mode after 1 minute from ignition off. It checks the level at every 2, 5, and 10 hours. If required, it compensates the level using compressor. Next, let's see some functions supported by scanner. As an actuator driving function, the level can be changed to low, normal, or high level by scanner. Seeing current data, the height sensor voltage has 2 5-volt for both left and right side. Because that control module sends only 2 signals at left and right sides for power supply of height sensor. ECS system air mass and reservoir air mass are represented in unit of bar liter. This unit means that 1 bar of compressed air is enclosed in the space of 1 liter. It represents the mass of air. When air is discharged from air spring will be shrunken. At this time, if air is filled when the vehicle is on the ground, buckling phenomena may occur. In this case, force is applied to the side direction of air spring so that the air spring may be damaged. Therefore, when filling air into the air spring, it should be done on the lifter. Finally, cautions for towing the vehicle. When the air spring is damaged, vehicle towing should be done carefully, even if flatbed truck is used, because the level is extremely low. If the approaching angle of guide lane is too steep, the front bumper may touch to the floor of guide lane so that the vehicle handling is required.